Hello, everybody. What's
hey,
up?
Hey, what's up?
Hey, that's my text.
Yeah, you're the host, man. Take it away.
Okay. So, welcome, everybody. Today, again, live. So, whatever can go wrong will go wrong. Because we're going to...
That's a nice intro.
I mean, normally it works like that.
I can tell you don't host many live streams anymore, do you?
Well, if we do live demo with something technical, normally the problems occur.
Usually you start the stream going, hey guys, welcome to another weekly Wednesday live stream. Today we're going to be talking about blah, blah, blah. Not today, everything that is that can go wrong will go wrong.
Yeah. Today we're going to talk about QB5. It's a mini PC, very small.
Yes.
We have some benchmark view. We're going to take it apart if we have time left. Because actually, we're going to disassemble it, tear it apart at the end of the live stream.
Yeah, we're going to see if we have time for it. So it depends on how fast we can go through the rest. Yeah.
And then next week, afterwards, I will drop it at our Ruud's place. Because we probably cannot put it back together.
We're gonna tear it apart, but there's no guarantee that we can actually... You know, put it back together again in working order. So
yeah, well, we will see. Anyway, this week also we have a live of a giveaway, a live stream, a giveaway.
We have a live giveaway.
Oh, actually, we have a nice giveaway. This week we have
your favorite game.
Well,
no, don't tell me you don't like it.
I played a bit.
Yeah, I know.
I did this one with Michiel. There was a.
It's maybe not exactly your favorite
type of game.
It's
not my type of game.
But I did hear, you know, very positive things about it.
It's a popular game.
It is, yeah. It's very popular.
And so Monster Hunter, Iceborne, I don't even know if it's an expansion pack.
Yeah, it's more like an expansion, yeah. So it's an expansion on the Monster Hunter world.
Anyway, you get the full game. You can play with it.
Yeah.
We're going to give away it. So please, I think our chatbot will
you'll have to go to,
spam you.
You'll have to go to msi.com/2/insider, as it shows above Eric's head right there. There should be a button. You know, guys who watch the stream multiple times, you know the drill. There you have to perform a couple of actions, like some of our channels, follow them, do whatever the system asks. The more actions you do, the bigger your chance to win. So yeah, and you only have to do it once per stream. So if you do it once, get it out of the way now, that's it. You're in the running for one of the, well, I don't know how many we have, but one of the game codes for Monster Hunter World Iceborne.
We have enough also for next week or maybe the week after.
We've got some of them, yeah.
Yeah, so we're live on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, Twitch.
Mixer.
Mixer as well, indeed. I'm not sure if on all the platforms the URL will show. Otherwise, go to msi.com/2/insider or join our YouTube chat. Yep. I see most people are active on there. If you have any questions, drop them in chat. Edwin K already, Kenneth Run, Android TV, and Cody. Good question. I don't know. Well, Android TV, I don't know if that. I mean, this is a normal PC.
By the way, so I see somebody in there who says, "I love arts." Do you see the name right there?
I think they mean some other art.
No.
It's not about you.
I love you too.
Oh, come on. Anyway, Kodi for sure it can run, because that will run on Windows platform.
Yes.
And Android TV, I'm not sure, that should be a x86 version.
Yeah, something. But we didn't try that yet. So that you can run it on Windows, probably. There's a good chance. We'll get into specifics later, but you'll see that this thing is quite surprisingly powerful for its size.
Yeah. Indeed.
And therein lies, I think, the secret where, you know, it can run quite a lot.
We started a few years ago, I think 2015 or something, Intel introduced a NUC platform.
Yes.
And this is the, let's say, the MSI version of NUC. In the last few years, a lot of changes have been made, optimizations. Yeah.
So what is the idea behind NUC? Some of you don't know.
It's a very small, compact mini PC, like you can see here, which you can put wherever you want.
Yep.
And this can be commercial, business. Later we will talk about that. This can also be your living room for your media center. It can be to play games on. Really. There is a big trend on the market. I mean, this doesn't have a discrete VGA.
No.
Discrete graphics card.
Not a dedicated graphics card. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
but because of the integrated chips,
the computer power in this is amazing.
Yeah, and because of the integrated chips, you know, in I don't know when they started with that, but quite a while ago. And those have gotten quite powerful. So because of that, we even have some data on if you want to play. We don't recommend you play games on it, but if you want and if you must, you can.
Let's maybe talk a little bit about the history.
Yeah.
So this is the first QB, 2015. Yeah, this was a very basic model. It already had USB 3.0 and nothing special. This is using a BGA CPU. So that's a CPU which is soldered on the PCB.
Yes.
Most of the times they're the mobile CPUs. You also find in notebooks.
Yeah. So you don't have the typical CPU if you build a PC, you know, the socketed thing. That's not what's in here. We'll show you a bit later as well, or at least we hope we can show you.
Yeah.
Depends on how far we get with the teardown.
Yeah, indeed. So after that, we introduced QB2. You already see Type-C there, a little bit different design.
Yep.
This was also a bit bigger. And then we had QB2 Plus. Actually, I have one.
We have it here, right?
Oh, well, hey, this is maybe interesting, Peter.
Yeah.
Maybe
first show. Have a bit of size comparison. So this is your typical ATX motherboard, right? So this is like full size. There is also extended ATX, so that's actually a bit bigger.
Yeah, but it's in the width, it's not in the height.
This is the normal size you would have typically in your PC.
Yeah.
This is an ITX motherboard,
yes.
So this is for specifically for small form factor builds, basically, right? This is something that, for example, Mike, who you see in the show
regularly.
Oh, he
loves this.
This is the size he loves.
Yeah,
because
that sounds really bad.
No, this is fine. He loves the small form factor builds. He's a big fan of that.
And this is something you cannot build yourself.
And then there's this. So this, as you can see, this is even a whole level smaller.
Indeed. And, later we will talk about size, etc. But it's like, I think 15 by 15.
Something like that.
Yeah, something like that, indeed.
I don't want to say it's tiny, because I've seen, you know, compute sticks and stuff. That is really small. But they're not anywhere near the amount of power that these things can.
So, and this is the QB2 Plus. This one, so you see it's already a lot bigger. This one also is using a 3.5 inch hard drive. This one is using, let me see, I think it's a desktop CPU. Broadwell S,
Yeah,
so it's a desktop CPU. So that's also why it's so big, because of the cooling, etc. And we have a lot of different versions of this.
Has probably a bit higher TDP because of that.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, here you're talking about 15 to 25 watt.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this one you're talking about 65 watt.
Yeah, that's quite a big difference.
That's a big gap indeed. But this also has different kind of purposes. Card reader inside and you also have a version of these with a COM port. That's for some hand scanners or some really some commercial usage, B2B stuff.
We'll get into how, you know, what the use cases basically are for these devices later.
You know
on.
What a cross means?
It's gone.
It's
all gone.
End of life.
Yeah.
End of life. That's
these
how we call this. We don't have this. Yeah. We don't have this anymore.
No. You can't buy these anymore.
So let's continue. This is QB3 Silent.
The
model after that.
Just a little bit.
This one was quite interesting because it was completely passive cooled.
Yeah.
This was
that's
the
why
first
you see
one.
You see at the top you see a little bit of, you know, that this breathing space. It's not it's not that it can
it's
get,
not for the
get
air
intake or something. It's more that it can, you know, the air can exhaust out of the top.
And dissipate then beneath the heat. It's one big radiator.
Yeah, beneath here there's like a big heat sink that can passively cool the whole thing.
Yeah, which indeed.
Is quite
and
nice.
This one was completely made of aluminium.
Yeah.
It was also a mobile CPU. I think this was Kaby Lake U, so also mobile form factor.
Yeah.
But
also
end of life.
Gone,
indeed. And now we have QBN. Let me take this one. So this is QBN.
That one's actually even smaller than...
This
than
is still available in
Maybe
the shops.
We can show it a little bit like this.
Yeah.
Just for the size
it's
comparison.
It's about the same size.
No, it's not. Look at that.
Yeah.
It's a little bit smaller.
This one is also passively cooled. Which means
no fan
indeed, no noise. The CPU in this platform is Celeron N400 or Celeron N5000. Oh, sorry, N4000, Celeron N4000 or Pentium N5000.
Right.
That's it. So they're quite slow.
Yeah.
They're really slow. You can do some office work on it. If you look at the rear I/O, there is an HDMI connector, a LAN port, of course, two USB, and a...
For basic office functionality, it's fast enough.
Yes.
But, I mean, you know, we're talking to you guys. You guys are, we assume, kind of used to, like, gaming level
A little bit faster
stuff.
Hardware.
So for you, this thing would be hella slow, you know?
Yeah.
But that's actually where this one comes in later on as well.
Move it.
Yeah.
So this is the QB. So here you see these five sizes. Oh, it's actually, it's 12 by 12.
Yeah.
And it's 5.
Let's say it's 12 and a half.
Yeah. It's 5.5 centimeters high. And I don't know if they included the screws, which I'm going to remove later.
I don't know.
Can you maybe check it in the detail cam?
Yeah, yeah.
Show it.
It's very clean design.
And yeah.
Well, you can clearly see where the name QB comes from, right? I mean, I hope that's obvious. It's a cube form. Well, not really a cube, because a cube would be more like, you know, an actual.
Yeah. This hole should not be there. This hole should be there. There's a Kensington lock.
Yes.
This one should not be there because I lost something.
Because hashtag blame Eric.
I think it's in here somewhere. So later I will find it.
Yeah.
Hashtag blame Eric again.
Yeah. You're here now, so.
Yeah. Okay. So also to compare it, it's about
the
same.
That was a hell of an animation there, I have to say. Can you do it again? Can you rewind it? There we go. Look at this, guys. Wow.
It's so bad. I didn't know how to do this. And it didn't fit in the background. Anyway, you know, just to show you, this is one thing is about size, but it's also about the volume indeed. Yeah. Because a can of Diet Coke, which I'm used to drink.
A normal soda can.
Yeah, normal basically. Soda can. It's about 0.33 liters.
Yeah.
This one is 0.66 liters.
So it's like two cans. That's why there's two cans on top.
I think in the past we had a live stream where we pour some water in it to really check.
That was a Trident 3 or something?
Yeah, Trident 3.
A Trident chassis at least. Yeah. So that was,
But I'm not going to do that today, so don't worry.
No. I think we made an aquarium out of it. There's like fish swimming around. I don't know.
Yeah. So what is juice for? What do you have for this?
Tell me, what can I help you with today, sir?
My computer is not booting. Help desk.
Have you tried turning it off and on again?
No. I'm sorry.
All right. In that case, try to do that.
Yeah. Okay. No, still doesn't boot.
Okay. Maybe I can sell you a nice new PC.
Yeah. So this is for office use. This is the there is a big commercial market for these kind of small PCs, and most people don't realize it. But for example, this is easy mountable on the back of a monitor with phaser mount. Later we will show you. Yeah. We will try to.
It's low power usage, which is also something that if you have a company, you're employing multiple of these PCs, basically, you know, the lower power usage you have, the better, because it saves the electricity bill a little bit, maybe.
I have a question. What components fit in this computer?
Yeah, we'll get to that.
Yeah, we will get
Stick
to
around.
That indeed.
Stick around.
We're going to talk about the internals as well. So office use, that's one thing.
Yeah. Yeah, if you have your man cave, right?
I have some. Cables here.
Are you?
Should I?
What are you?
This is for the connection.
Look at what you did.
Oh, sorry. I will put them back.
God.
Yeah.
Eric.
No. Yeah.
But yeah, I think it's okay. Don't touch anything.
Anyway, so this is a nice solution for your home server. What do you need for a home server?
Storage.
Well, storage, of course. You can have a NAS for this. You can have some people use a USB 3 or USB 3.1 HDD. But this, you can fit in a hard disk. You can fit in an M.2 SSD. So
it has plenty of USB connectivity as well for external storage solutions. We will show you later as well.
1 gigabit LAN. It's very small, so it fits everywhere in your man cave.
Yeah.
This looks really great because it has a bar inside.
I know. I want this.
Yeah.
Can you get me a drink?
This is how my basement should look.
Yeah. You're giving me ideas here. I'm not sure.
I can give you a drink.
I'm not sure that the wife approves.
No, I don't think so.
Let's see. Anyway, we need a hideaway.
Yeah,
maybe indeed. We should build the office like that. I don't know.
So a home server, small PC. It's really low power. Later we will try to show you that, and then this can run 24 hours without consuming too much energy.
Yeah.
As well, a hotel. There are a lot of hotels where these are used because What are you looking for?
I actually had a bag here, but I forgot to. I forgot it.
We already practiced this morning. Yeah. Peter was okay. Well, okay.
I was supposed to put a bag in here. You know, like I would like to check in, and then he would say, "Can I see your passport?" And I would say, "Oh, I knew I forgot something." And, you know, whatever. Anyway,
for a hotel, yeah. They need a lot of space. Yeah. This is very small,
like front desk type of thing. You can imagine.
And there are also versions of this with like QB with serial ports for the label printers, etc.
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Oh, bad. Very... I told you already. You should not make bad jokes.
It's fine. Don't
worry. Well,
yeah.
What about
this
one?
Wait.
Yeah.
Let's put on the 3D glasses.
It's mine has a little bit of a problem.
It's been in the storage for so long because how do they
do this with?
Remember when 3D was a thing? Remember? Like,
so this for your home movie theater.
Nice.
This
so what
is like Fortnite,
playing?
Right?
I love it.
Yeah. Anyway.
Right. You're doing the cleanup later on.
No. You're off tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Anyway.
I think it will smell like popcorn tomorrow here.
I love that smell.
I'm a bit sticky. I don't know why.
I love that smell.
Yeah.
Anyway, so yeah, you know, home theater setting, that kind of thing, because it can very easily play any kind of content that you need to play. You have some specifics.
Yeah. Later, I will show you. Well. I will show some things. Yeah. So this one can.
It's a very good question, by the way. Can it run virtual machines at Windows?
Yes, it can. This is a mobile CPU which has the VM extensions, virtual machine extensions, so without problem. And that's also nice for a home server. Yeah. You can either run Docker or something like VMware or what's it called? Virtual PC.
Yeah, there's a lot of things. Yeah.
Without any problem.
In short, the answer, yes.
Yeah,
so
indeed.
That's very nice.
Yeah, but of course, you need to have enough memory and enough storage to support this.
Yes.
But CPU power is no problem.
Yes.
So let's have a look at the front connectivity. I'm going to clean it a little bit.
Watch out, man. It's the perfect moment. I say, don't speak English. Don't worry. Neither does Eric.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think that will never improve.
No, don't worry about it.
I'm not worried. Okay.
Nobody's paying attention to that.
Yeah. So can you maybe switch to the...
Yes, I can. If I can find, there we go.
Yeah. So front, we have
connectivity.
Sorry.
Yes.
Connectivity. We have the headphone in, microphone of a headphone out.
It's focusing on me, the camera. Let's see if I can. Here. You need to focus.
No, you do the finger. I will. So headphone.
Focus.
Headphone out. Microphone in. USB 3.1. Yes. USB 3.2. It's confusing
Gen
those
one.
Names.
Gen 1. Yeah, nobody.
This is the 5 gigabit version, basically.
Well, is this is the current fastest USB connection?
No.
Oh crap! I thought maybe I could simplify it, but nah.
Oh, this is 10 gig. This 10 gig.
Okay.
And then you have also a Type-C connector.
Yes.
This is a small LED for your storage. And I'm not going to say HDD because also SSD.
Yeah.
And then
a power button.
A power button on off. Yeah. Maybe you can show the rear.
Click. All right. There we go.
So rear I.O. Let's start over here. 65 watt power adapter. So it has an external power adapter. But it's quite small. Let me... Can you maybe switch the camera, Peter?
Yes. There we go.
Yeah. So this is it.
Yeah. It's like a really small notebook adapter,
I guess. Indeed. 65 watt, but it doesn't draw that power.
No.
I see popcorn everywhere.
You'll say, that was what I was going for.
Yeah.
All right. Back to the...
Yeah. Hey. We still need to...
You started.
Yeah, well, I had still some...
Don't start things you don't plan to finish,
I
Eric.
Still had something left.
Right. Okay.
So, 65 watt power adapter. Let me see. Yeah, so two USB 2.0 connectors. USB 3.2.
Gen 1.
Gen 1,
yes.
Indeed.
Type A.
LAN, of course. Gigabit LAN, Intel. And then we have HDMI 1.4, and this is important. And DisplayPort, I think DisplayPort is 1.2. Let me check. Yeah.
Yes.
So, yeah.
So I think HDMI 1.4B or 1.4?
To be honest, I don't know.
Anyway, you say it's important. Why? Because I think people want to know.
If we talk about, I mean, we said it's you can use this for your home theater. Then it's also important. What kind of content do you want to play?
Yes.
And if you talk about 4K 60 FPS, content is not only movies, but it's also games or something, then you need HDMI 2.0. And this one doesn't have HDMI 2.0.
No.
But for 4K 30.
You can go up to 30 FPS on 4K, right?
4K 30, no problem.
If you're okay with movies,
1080p.
30, then that's fine.
60, no problem at all.
Yep.
So, are you sticky?
Always.
Always.
Yeah. Okay.
So let's talk about the CPU. Monster Hunt, Iceborne, that's the giveaway. Nice games.
I saw
two kids playing. Yeah,
I know.
And we get paid for it.
I think that's my job description. Mm-hmm. Right at the top. Does it support VR? I'm pretty sure. It depends on what you mean.
Was it VR?
Yeah, VR, as in virtual reality. I'm not sure. Maybe if you say virtual reality content that you can play, as in like a movie, probably yes, I would say. You know, with VR glasses, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
But if you mean like VR games, no. I don't think it's powerful enough for that.
Well, you know, the CPU is quite powerful. The problem in that is the GPU,
exactly.
Indeed.
Yeah.
And for VR, also depending on what kind of resolution, because the newer VR glasses, they have a really high resolution.
4040p or something, right? I think.
Some are moving 4040p. You also have some Chinese vendors who are moving to 4K per eye.
Wow.
So basically,
8K.
Yeah, 8K indeed. And then what do you need for 8K? It's like 2080 Ti.
Dual.
Dual, like SLI.
Well, it depends on how demanding the title.
The settings, etc. Yeah.
So speaking of that, you know, the new upcoming the Alex. What was
The new Half-Life.
Yeah.
That's a new VR title, and this will be really interesting because it will push the limits of VR not only based on interfacing, how you move inside the world, but also based on graphics.
Yeah.
Really nice trailer. I'm looking forward to it. Maybe we're going to check how we can do a live stream on VR with the green screen, but need to have time to check how everything works. So VR, no, this is not perfect for VR.
Six cores, six.
Yeah, so let's go to the CPU. He already checked, I'm sure.
Well, that's the top.
So this is the Comet Lake platform.
Let me just get out of the way. It's okay, I'm hanging in there. Hurry up. No. Hurry up.
Yeah, okay. This model comes with the Comet Lake platform. Like we already said, it's a mobile CPU. It's soldered on the PCB, so it's a BGA packing or a SoC.
Yes.
There is no chipset inside. Everything is inside the CPU. Three CPUs, which we're going to support in this. There are more CPUs in the lineup. You have an i3, i5, and i7.
Yeah.
And it's ranging from a two-core with four threads,
so,
four-core, or quad-core, or a six-core. Yeah, indeed.
Well, this is, it's two physical cores, and then because this is hyper-threading, right?
Indeed.
Four threads.
Yeah.
That jazz.
And you have different TDPs.
See just next to Eric's head, basically.
It's
from the top down, you see the TDPs.
Yeah.
Yes.
So it's configurable, and this one is running 25 watt, because then you get most performance out of it. Because it's running on an adapter.
Yeah.
And this is not mobile, there is no battery inside.
No.
If you have a notebook, a lot of notebook vendors, of course, are downclocking them. I don't want to say downclocking, but they configure the TDP as being a 15-part...
Undervolting, I think?
It's configurable TDP.
They already asked. They want it to fit inside a certain TDP package.
Yeah,
and to do that,
it has to do with thermals. It has to do with battery life, the number of hours you want to achieve.
Yeah.
I already asked one of our engineers, and he is going to check that. Can we support that the consumer, the purchaser of these kind of products, that it's possible if they can configure the TDP
themselves? Like in the BIOS or something.
He's looking into it. I'm not sure if it is possible, but it would be a cool feature, right?
Would make it a bit more. You can choose if you want it to be as low power as possible. You can tune it down even further, maybe. Or if you wanted to get, as much performance out of it as possible, you could also do that. So maybe would give you a bit more possibilities.
Power cord, you lost it. No. I have it here.
It's still there. So, can it run Crysis? Did we try?
No, you asked me not to do some benchmarks. I wanted to play some games on it. I was already ready to install some. Which game did I want to install?
I think it didn't get beyond the Cry.
I want Fortnite. Fortnite. Not Fortnite. Hey, come on. It's already epic. Anyway.
What?
Fortnite.
I think you just gave them a new idea for a game.
Yeah.
Fortnite. Okay. All right.
Yeah, anyway. We have some game benchmarks.
This is what I have to work with, guys.
Yeah, I'm
like,
sorry.
Seriously.
And it was not on purpose.
No, I know. That's the thing.
Yeah, it's my English. Oh, look
this
at my head.
This is what you're like normally as well.
Yeah, I know.
Not just
I know.
On stream.
Anyway, one thing I want to highlight are the turbos. They're quite aggressive, and that helps with performance as well, especially, you know, unzipping something.
Yes. Yeah.
So let's have a look at CPU performance. We're not going to do any live benchmark. This is a Core i5 version.
Yeah.
Not going to do live benchmarks because we are having some problem with our capturing. As soon as we're capturing via NDI, and as soon as we connect the LAN cable so that we can capture via NDI, it crashes. Actually, the live stream crashes. As you remember when we did the AMD live stream end of last year. Martijn from AMD.
You learned some new things, right?
Yeah.
If we disconnect the cable with NDI, then...
And the last few weeks, we didn't need it. So we can also capture via our capture card, but then the colors are... Anyway, so... Yeah. Looking into it will be fixed soon.
By the way, that some people saying, you know, I also think that Fortnite stinks.
Yeah.
Anyway...
So let's talk a little bit about CPU performance before we go to the giveaway.
So which one? We've got one highlighted. Which one is it? It's the one.
Well, actually,
in the middle, right?
Yeah, two are highlighted. Yeah. The middle one is the 15 watt, and this is the 25 watt. That's the green on the top. So and these are all mobile CPUs, and I just took a CPU benchmark. So this is the encoding. You can also look at scores like.
Decoding or, you know...
WinZip, WinRAR, those kind of
all
applications.
Kinds of scenarios. It's just to give you guys some indication.
Yeah. And of course, this will vary per benchmark.
Yeah. You've got so many different things, so this is just meant to give you some kind of a concept of...
And like what I already said, we have three versions of it. We have a Core i3, Core i5, and a Core i7.
Seven, yeah, of course.
And this is the benchmark for the Core i7.
Yeah.
10710U. And U is for ultra-low voltage.
Yeah.
And this is compared with other notebook...
I see some questions also. Is there a Ryzen version at the moment? No.
No, we are not planning a Ryzen version or an AMD version for that matter, whatever the platform is called at this moment.
No.
We're still looking into that indeed. Yeah. Who knows?
Does it have a Thunderbolt connection? Well, it has a Type-C. I don't think it's Thunderbolt,
no,
right?
No, this is not Thunderbolt. No. The platform, indeed, he's correct. The platform supports Thunderbolt. That's also why in more and more notebooks nowadays, we are using this ultra-low voltage platform.
Yeah.
They have Thunderbolt, or they will come with Thunderbolt. But Thunderbolt comes at a cost. And if you look at the markets where this is focused on, Thunderbolt
is not being used that much.
No, indeed.
Because, you know, remember, even though there's an i7 in there, again, you know, with let's go back to the main view. With the, basically the scenarios that we just highlighted, where you should expect to use these things, Thunderbolt is usually not one of the most used devices that you'll encounter.
Yeah, I see a question which relates, it's related to this. Does it support an external GPU? Yes and no. I mean, you have a lot of external GPUs on the market which use like USB.
Yeah.
Yes, it supports via USB.
Yeah.
But to be honest, I mean, the ones I saw, they don't have the speed. I mean, USB is quite bandwidth limited.
Yeah.
So you want to go for Thunderbolt. And this is also the dilemma of all those external GPUs. Thunderbolt is only available in new quite high-end devices. So you want the ultra-thin notebook with a fast CPU, but you don't want the GPU inside. And that's where the external GPUs are useful. So you need to have something with Thunderbolt, and this one doesn't have. So, but you know, I mean, Thunderbolt will get a big push. I don't know when. I think later this year, because you already saw on CES, Thunderbolt 3 will also be, I don't know if it will be called Thunderbolt 4, but it will be USB 4.0.
Yeah.
And I mean, maybe, I don't know, but maybe they will introduce it this year. And then, of course, it will still take some years before this will come standard in all the machines. And it will become much cheaper. And then Thunderbolt will become much more mainstream. This takes time. It's same with USB.
Yeah, that's the thing. You know, it's for us, for example, whenever there's a new standard, PCI Gen 4, you know, what we're on now with the AMD platforms. Yeah. We've been hearing this for some how long already?
Oh,
so for us this is like old news, right? But for most people, I mean, how long have any of you been using PCIe Gen 4, and do you even notice the benefits? Probably in some very specific cases, maybe.
Well, for storage, Gen 4 has a big advantage.
It's
much higher speed.
Yeah.
And if you're going to look at
for graphics cards as well,
I think not yet really,
but in
the future, professional use, if you look at the.
Sure.
I don't know how they're called, the AMD.
But my point is that it's going to take a while for the mainstream to get any benefit out of this feature.
New game engines, etc.
Yeah. It will take a while. DX12.
Hello, Hussein.
DX12.
Yeah, indeed.
That's like years already?
Literally years. There are some nice game engines
which really. But you see how long it takes before you start to notice it. Yeah. Apart from the first, you know, the first month gimmicks that people say, we've adapted it to DirectX 12, you already see a little bit of benefit.
Yeah, Mr. Masterdox is right. I mean, a lot of people...
I see the question. I think it's based on my Sarah's question. QB5 versus DIY PC with the same spec. And what would make you want a QB5? And I think SpoofPass quite...
Then its size.
Quite well put it indeed. He says, look, if you want the same PC based on the same specs, it will never be this size. It will be... Here we've got...
Mini ITX.
This is kind of like... And this is just the motherboard. So then you still need a chassis around it. So it will be about 1.5 times bigger at the smallest.
Yeah.
So if size matters for you, if really, you know, you want it to be this small, there's not much other options, I would say.
Bryce has a question. What is included in the giveaway? The base game DLC or DLC only? I already know the base game and the DLC.
Yeah.
I mean, why would we give away the DLC? Later.
I don't know. So if you only get the DLC in the end, you know who to ask.
No problem. Just come to me. I will fix that.
Speaking of which, do you think it's time?
Yeah. For the giveaway.
For a winner.
Yeah.
Right. So you do the talking. I do the drawing.
Well, depends. I mean, Michiel and me, Mike and me, we have a rule. Depending on the difficulty of the name.
Yeah. That's nice. So Mike and you have a rule. How does this concern me?
It also applies. Hey, you have the wrong one, not?
No. This is the right one.
Yeah?
Yes. So, we'll draw our first winner. Eric, direct them to how they can participate.
Yet. So, Monster Hunter, Iceborne, really nice game. And I say that without laughing. Okay, it's not my game, but it's a nice game. It's a very popular game.
It is.
This one is for me.
Yeah?
Yeah, Jason. Congratulations.
Jeffo, actually.
Well, I mean, his name is Jason. Jeffo. Well,
just say the nickname.
It's Jeffo. Sometimes nicknames are more difficult Jeffo. Than the real names.
In this case, it's not.
Okay. Jeffo. Jeffo, congratulations. In the coming days, we will send you an email with the game code for Monster Hunter Iceborne. You can participate in the giveaway if you go to msi.com/2/insider or our spam bot will spam it. Not on all platforms, so at least on YouTube.
Like, it looks like Facebook, because we can kind of see where it posts. Facebook, Mixer, Twitch, and YouTube.
Yeah.
So if you're watching it on any of our Twitter channels, there's actually multiple that we're broadcasting it on, Periscope channels basically.
Yeah.
There, unfortunately, there's the bot can't post it. Oh God.
Yeah.
This is becoming a meme now.
Hashtag Eric. Hashtag Fortnite.
Yeah, Fortnite. Yeah.
Fortnite. Let's continue.
So if you say it in a strong Scottish accent, it probably will work. You'll get away with it.
Yeah, Fortnite. Indeed. Well, Battlefield 4 or 5.
Yeah. Okay. Well, let's continue. So, guys, we've got more codes to give away, so you can still participate. Just follow the link or go to msi.com/2/insider. And yeah.
The performance matter, not size.
Sorry?
Super bad cat. Performance matters, not size.
It depends on who you ask. that sounded wrong.
You have children. Oh, you have a child.
I have a child, yeah. No, okay. But I mean, for some people, they just want a small PC, and that's it. And, the performance is like, meh, as long as it's okay, it's fine.
Well, with the upcoming platforms later this year, we will also talk more about mini ITX. But I don't know what time frame, but that's for later. Powerful mini ITX platforms.
Yes.
So, GPU. So I wanted to install some games.
Yeah, there you go.
Peter said, no, don't do it.
Well, you know, here's the thing. It's not a gaming device. So, you can play some games on it, but we don't really recommend it. And here you can pretty much see why.
Well, League of Legends, 1080p, ultra settings.
You can do it. It's fine.
86, but that says enough about the game, right?
It's fine. But if you have a monitor, a proper gaming monitor with 144 hertz, you're still not getting a good experience.
No, absolutely not. Now, Fortnite, 720p, low settings. So probably you cannot...
Which game?
I said Fortnite. So probably you can only see pixels in the distance. FIFA 18 1080p medium setting, only 38 frames per second. So
the memes are getting better and better. Yeah. I will eat Mexican today so I can have myself a game of Fortnite. Nice.
So yeah, this is not a gaming platform, but Peter, what about gaming emulators? There are a lot of old game consoles where you can find some games, some legal, some illegal.
We don't mention those, do we?
Yeah, indeed. But
Eric, remember what the legal department told you?
No. So, what about indie games? I mean, Overcooked.
There's party games.
Yeah, party games.
And 2D games.
Overcooked is indie perfect games for this.
So some of them you can do. Again, it's not really recommended. Don't buy this thing if you want to game on. That's kind of what we want to say, because it's not built for that. We've got way better devices for that. Yes, they're a bit bigger, but they also have way better performance.
What you already saw on CES, Intel is also working on their own graphics, which probably
somebody mentioned that. He said at CES, Intel had their new NUC, and it actually had enough space to fit a dedicated GPU.
Yes, indeed.
So that means, guys, it's a hell of a lot bigger than this.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
So that's the downside. And so if size does matter for you, it's probably not really an option for you.
Yeah, it's probably 8 to 10 times bigger. Then you talk about 8 liters, 10 liters.
You're getting into how many liters was our Trident? A bit more than that, maybe. Infinite S. That one's pretty small as well, right? You'll get into that territory. So actually, we already have PCs on that size. With great performance,
but they want to build it.
And a dedicated GPU. You can pretty much build those
systems.
Yeah. Indeed. I mean, the Intel NUC, if you want to build it, that's also not what you're going to buy, right? So, anyway.
But this one has a lot of multimedia functions. Intel HD graphics, it's called, the integrated graphics. It's office device, Hussein said. Yeah. So, office device.
It is. Yeah. But you can still, that's why we're explaining this. If you want to use it for entertainment
purposes.
Like
multimedia, it has
movies and stuff.
Yeah, nice features, VP9 support, HDCP 2.2, which you need for Netflix, actually Netflix 4K at least. Yeah. So there are a lot of arguments for that.
Yeah.
We're not going to do any live benchmarks.
FIFA 18, yikes on that.
Yeah, yeah. Well, hey, but we want to show you...
Do you mean yikes on the game?
No, I guess it's the performance.
No. Maybe it's just somebody who doesn't like the game or who's thinking, why 18? That's like...
Hey, and to be honest, these are the more positive benchmarks because there are a lot of benchmarks which score like only 18 or something. If you take like Battlefield or the...
Did not boot.
It did not boot. No. I think the drivers in Intel are very good nowadays.
Yeah, but I mean, if you want to start something like, I don't know, like the latest Battlefield game, that's just not going to work.
I think it will run.
No.
It will not be smooth, but it probably 7 frames per second.
I think it will cost you better part of an hour to, yeah, to maybe start the game. Yeah,
possible,
even.
Possible. So anyway. So let's talk about Wi-Fi, because this machine can come with two different Wi-Fi modules inside, either Wi-Fi 5, 5 or 6. Both are Intel, so you have the AC9462 or you have the AX200, indeed. Yeah, so this is where the speed difference is.
At the moment, only the versions with Wi-Fi 5 are available, right? As far as we know.
Yes, no, we are shipping indeed only the Wi-Fi 5 versions at this moment, but later on, it's certified for Wi-Fi 6, so the antenna internal. I don't know when they will ship, but we will also have like Bluetooth 5. But
yes.
Anybody still using Bluetooth? I'm wondering. I mean,
but
I use it
PC,
in my...
I don't know.
No, I mean, I use it in my car.
Sometimes accidentally.
Yeah. Headphones, but for this?
I don't know. Depends.
Yeah, I mean, it's on there.
Some people use Bluetooth mice. Right?
Yeah, so somebody's saying, if you don't have an AX router, the AX is not needed indeed. An AX router, they're becoming more available.
Yeah.
Also, prices are coming down. What we like, I mean, as gamers, more of these AX routers, so the Wi-Fi 6 routers, they also have 2.5 or even some have 10 gigabit. Connection, so LAN connection, so that's quite interesting
for your network, indeed. So some people Bluetooth for control, so yeah, peripherals.
Somebody from MSI Dubai watching, hello,
what's up?
Our colleague,
I have no way to confirm that, really. Could just be anyone,
I think it's,
but who knows?
Who would lie on the live stream?
Why would you,
So, a little bit about bare bone or full system, because we have two different versions of the QB5. And I can already switch it on, right? Yeah, oh, people see the LED.
Yeah. Maybe we can show it in the
detailed cam.
There you go. It's on, guys.
Yeah.
It's
on. So you see the HD LED as well?
Yeah.
It's blue, but.
Yeah, there we go. When it's flashing, you can see it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You see, he can prove it to us. He can company email
that's
us.
That's fine.
Good. We believe you. So, bare bone or full system.
You don't get a game code just because you can do that, by the way.
He probably already has some.
Actually, it disqualifies you if you're trying to win.
Yeah.
Anyway.
We need to remember his name. So, either a bare bone or full system, what does it mean? And this is something you really need to pay attention for, because some people, they want to buy a full system. Basically, it means without storage. Without an SSD or HD or both.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes. With. Well, okay. I'm talking full system.
Yeah, full system includes it all.
With storage.
You can see the checklist above.
Yeah,
Eric.
Indeed. Yep. With memory and with operating system, Windows 10. And it can be Windows 10. On this one, most of the times Windows 10 Home. On the other one, I threw away somewhere, the QBN.
Right.
This one, I think it's Pro. Yeah.
Yeah,
don't ask me why.
Right,
probably we got a good deal from Microsoft.
Probably. Probably.
Yeah, pro.
Pun intended.
So, but we also have it as a bare bone. And depending on the territory, some territories, they only sell the bare bone. Some, they have the full system. Some have both. So you really need to pay attention for this. I try to figure out in our internal systems, what is the difference in naming? Well, it's difficult. If you get a very, really long name with a lot of characters inside, it's a full system.
Basically, you need to check.
Yeah,
and probably
check.
It will be listed as a bare bone or a full system or something like that.
I mean, if it says 60...
If they mention an OS, it's a full system. Yeah, you can probably kind of... Anyway.
So, and a bare bone, you need to assemble yourself, not like assemble completely from scratch, because the mainboard is inside. You just need to open it at the bottom. We are going to do that, right?
We're
going to
show you later on,
Open it, install the memory, very easy, it's SODIMM. Install the SSD or a hard drive or a M.2 SSD, whatever you want. And you need to install your OS and then you're set to go. Both have an adapter, the 65 watt adapter we talked
is
about.
Is included always.
Is included indeed. Yeah. And 2 years warranty.
I saw some people also asking, can we see what's in the package or unboxing? I don't think we can do a full unboxing, but we can show you.
You can.
Well, but there's nothing in there, right? We already
took
it out.
I know.
So there's nothing to unbox.
Okay, so what is in the packing?
It's the QB itself.
Yeah.
Let's say for the full system. It's the QB itself and everything in it, of course, all the hardware. It's the adapter. It's a Visa mount plate.
Yeah.
For specifically for the QB, so it'll fit, obviously.
It's a very small SATA power cable.
Yeah.
And it's a very small, short, yeah, but short enough
SATA connector
indeed. Yeah. So this is for your hard drive. Later we will show you how to upgrade this.
Yeah.
We just leave it here.
So that's what should be in the box. Is this thing also included?
No, that's not included.
Okay.
A manual and yeah, some screws. Yeah, yeah. Ja already lost some screws, I see.
Ja was here, yeah.
He's
on holiday now. Yeah. Hope you enjoy if you're watching. But yeah, it's like the blame Eric, right? It's like the hashtag blame Eric.
Yeah,
but if it's about screws, it's like, yeah, Ja was here.
So some pricing information, because I know you're always asking, and some configurations. So I know in Europe, and this probably applies to the US and other territories as well.
Yes.
We're at this moment selling 3 SKUs, like what I already told you. One with i7, one with i5, and one with
i3.
I3. Yeah. All of them are configured with Wi-Fi 5 at this moment. And the pricing is, including VAT, in euros. For the i7 is 599. For the i5, it's 449. And for the... I need to check this. For the i3, it's 349. So... Yeah.
This is an indication price, right?
Yeah, this is an indication price, including euro, including, let's say, 20%. I think this is maybe 21% VAT.
Yeah.
US dollar pricing, it's the same.
Pretty much.
Yeah, this is always...
Translates.
About the same. That's without VAT, and each state has different VAT. If you are looking to a full system, which basically includes storage, OS, and memory...
Yeah.
Then it's like $200 higher, I would say.
Mm.
Depends, of course. I mean, if you have 4 gig, 8 gig, yeah, or whatever, yeah, 32 gig.
Yeah. But remember, this thing already includes the CPU, which is the most,
yes,
important and probably one of the most expensive,
absolutely,
parts anyway.
Yeah.
So
yeah, indeed. Yeah, so that's let's say $200, 200 euro plus on it, and depends, yeah, on the configuration.
So somebody's already asking, are the chips soldered in? Are they,
yes,
upgradable later? So no, the CPU is actually soldered in,
yes,
so you cannot upgrade it later.
Yeah. We will try to...
show you it later on.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Something, yeah. Some popcorn. Everywhere popcorn.
Yes. So we have a nice monitor here.
Yeah, so this is not gaming, you know? It's not curved.
You can see it's flat. This is an office monitor.
Yeah, this is something you probably don't know from us. This is MP221. It's a 1080p TN panel, 60 FPS. I'm a gamer.
You're thinking FPS.
Yeah, yeah. Anyway, it has an HDMI connector, D-sub connector.
Yeah. It's a typical, your typical office monitor.
Yeah. Yep. Why I took this?
Yep.
I need to switch it off. Because of the VESA mount.
Here you go.
Yes. So these four holes, VESA mount, yeah, there are actually two kinds of VESAs, 75 and 100.
Yeah.
I'm just going to... No, I
Do
should.
You wanna...
I'm going to power it down like I should. Yeah, yeah. Screwdriver.
Yeah. Don't screw up.
Well, what I'm going to do, maybe we can see it in the detail cam. Oh, well, like this is also. So, this is the VESA mount plate. Panic,
yes.
Peter.
Oh, no?
Yeah.
Okay, you wanna... Okay.
Oh, yeah, like this. So, this is a VESA mount plate. And basically, if you look very carefully, you see how it will attach QB. So, there are some keyholes.
Like it's wider at one point and then it gets more narrow at the other.
Yeah. So I should turn it around. Yes. Wow.
Basically, the little protruding bit you have to stick into the wider part and then
it's
gravity basically. So you have to have it so that the gravity kind of holds it locks it into place.
Yeah. So I'm going to mount this. The arrow probably means up, right?
Yeah. You think?
Yeah. Well, I never did this, so. One of the problems I have, I only have two screws.
That's fine. It's
because
for this demonstration, I think it will be just fine.
We need to do something because Ja, he keeps losing everything, like screws.
I think you need to screw it in a bit more. And in the end, I think it needs to go in all the way.
No. Oh, yeah.
Or else you can't.
You never should first put one screw in and screw it all the way. Otherwise, it will...
No. How else are people going to learn? They need to make mistakes.
Yeah, that's true. Like Threadripper, that socket is really like 1, 2, 3, 4. It's all numbered.
Yeah, I know. And still, people...
Yeah.
Well, anyway. So here you've got it. Maybe put it this way for the camera, for the main cam. I think it's fine.
Yeah. So, and now you can put QB like this. I need to think.
Go on.
Yeah. Like this.
There you go.
And it's mounted on the back.
However, what I mean, okay, imagine I'm you know,
You're Peter.
I'm working on this thing. Yeah, imagine I'm Peter. Imagine that, you know? Wow. Mind blown. But imagine this is your PC and you have to work on it. So you arrive at the office and you have to turn it on. You know, how do I? So we've got something nice for that as well, don't we?
Yeah. Give your hand.
Why?
Just like this. It works. No, we have something like this.
I don't see that.
I mean, this one is not included in the box. But
show
we...
It in the detailed cam. There you go.
Yeah. This is a... Like a...
An extended power switch.
Power switch.
Yeah.
On off.
Yes.
So what I'm going to do... I already told you...
There's a little hole there that shouldn't be a hole.
Erik and getting this off.
Yeah, normally there's a nice plastic
yeah.
placeholder there to.
Yeah, so here there's a small gap. You see two pins. Yeah. Normally there's a protector in it, and yeah.
That one is in there right now. Somewhere.
Yeah, somewhere. We will find it.
Yes. Hopefully during the teardown.
The connector, you just put it in.
There you go.
And then you can very easy click on the button. Hey. Oh. Hey, am I doing this?
Can you stop pressing?
No. Oh, cool. Anyway, so that's it for this connector. Yeah. So let's put it back on it like this.
Yes. Well, actually, do you want to do that right now? Because
and then I mean, this is just the one I found on our FAE. Yeah. Our technical guys have this. And I mean, this doesn't look really professional.
You have a picture of one.
Oh,
that looks more.
This there one. You go. Yeah. So and then you can mount it at the back of the monitor, so you can
push
it
here. Or at the side, or the front, or whatever.
Indeed. And this is a lot used for devices which are not easy, like what you mentioned.
When it's
already
on the back, it's hard to, you know, you'll have to like stand up and go like, where's the freaking power button?
I asked our R&D department, I said, can you ship me this button? No. I said, okay, I will find one myself. Yeah, so that's what you get.
Yeah.
That's what you get.
There is
even some popcorn on the back of the monitor.
I know. You get it for free.
Can you show Peter?
On the detailed cam?
Yeah,
there's a little bit of popcorn. Just to show you guys, that wasn't part of like the green screen trickery. That was real.
Sugar.
Oh my God.
Sugar.
You already failed your diet for today.
More sugar. Need sugar.
Feed me.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. So let's put this aside.
Yep.
I would.
So let's remove the button for now.
Yeah, indeed. So let's talk a little bit about how to upgrade this. As you can see in the back, it's quite easy to upgrade. At the bottom there are 4 screws. You can take the bottom
off.
We
say it's easy to upgrade. And now Erik is going to show you.
Maybe first do the giveaway. Yeah, I mean...
No pressure.
Yeah, then I can prepare
a
little
bit.
I can check the manual.
Sure. Okay, so again, guys, we have a giveaway today for Monster Hunter World Iceborne. A very nice game. Erik loves it. He recommends it. 10 out of 10. He plays it all the time.
Great.
Yes.
Amazing.
Yes. And you can get it free.
Can you check what price this game is?
No.
Yeah, you can check.
No. Well, maybe. It depends.
Because this is not like... This is better than a $20 Steam voucher.
I don't know.
We're Googling.
It takes a while. Don't worry.
Easy.
It's about...
Like 40 USD.
No. Well, that's on G2A. That's not the official price, is it? So that's why I'm looking for like Steam or something?
Yeah, Steam.
Where is it? Steam? Here we go. Yeah, $40.
Yeah, $40. It's double than normal.
Yeah. It's a nice and price,
it's amazing game.
It's amazing.
If you like dragons.
No, monsters. Yeah, and hunting them.
There are also dragons inside.
Those are monsters.
Yeah.
But not Lucky. Because if you see him in game...
Don't kill him.
Yeah. Because just no, you don't do it. We'll call RSPCA,
okay, so
whatever.
If you want to win this game, please go to amazon.com/2/insider, without S. Or check our spam bot. He's having another URL. If you're on Twitter, please go to our YouTube channel,
yes,
or go to this URL.
Yeah, this one's definitely yours.
Oh my god. And the next... Oh my god. And the next winner is...
We'll just say...
Makoto?
Yeah, just Makoto, I think.
Makoto?
It's fine.
Makoto!
Yeah. Congratulations.
And the rest we will skip, Makoto.
Of the name. Yeah,
congratulations.
Sorry, it's a bit hard for us to pronounce.
Yeah.
But I think if it's you, you probably know
Who you are. Bryce played Monster Hunter on the PSP.
Yeah, there you go. So, okay. So we've got more prizes to give away. Stick around. Make sure you participate. And you can also win a copy of the game. So Eric is ready now, guys. Eric is ready. Let's not delay this any further. let's make sure Eric gets his
opening is quite easy.
Can you do it? Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, just four screws at the bottom. I should not lose them.
No.
Otherwise, I'm no better than Ja.
Otherwise,
we cannot make jokes anymore.
Exactly. Otherwise, you lose the
right to make jokes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
Are you nervous by any chance?
No.
All right.
Okay, so...
Don't worry, I'm a professional.
Yeah. Yeah, that's okay. It. So this is the bottom plate.
Yeah.
This is Ja proof.
Yeah, you can... Well...
No.
We'll have to let Ja play with it and then we'll know for sure.
And at the same time, these are the rubber feet.
Yes. Because you need a little bit of space under it. You can see also, maybe you can show there's a little bit of space in there so it can get air from the bottom.
Yeah.
So that's also why you need a little bit of space underneath it so the air can get through.
So this is the bottom. Let's put this away.
Yes.
Yeah, we have a green screen, so it looks a little bit strange.
Some of the PCB is being a little bit jittery.
Blacked out. Yeah, anyway, let me see how to best show this to you. So we have two DIMM slots. One is filled in this case, and this, let me check. This is 4 gig. If you have an 8 gig, it's possible to get 2x4 or 1/8. To be honest, I'm not sure.
Yeah.
But this one you can easily upgrade. Just take another DIMM.
Yeah.
Make sure it's the same speed. So this is a SO DIMM. So that a small DIMM you find in notebooks. We need to fix this with a green screen on the table. 2666. So just DDR4, by the way. Just put it in. Click. And that's it.
If you've ever upgraded a notebook, it's very similar.
Yeah, very easy. That's it. And of course, you need to reboot. Probably your BIOS will complain.
I'm just checking, because you mentioned the memory. It's DDR4, 2066 megahertz.
Yeah.
And you can have up to 64 gigs.
I know.
So that's fine.
But I don't know if you have a full system, if you order an 8 gig model, get 2x4 or you get 1x8.
Well, that indeed you'll have to check. I don't know exactly either. But I think important to know is if you want to upgrade it, you want to know how far, how much can I put in there?
Oh, yeah, max 64. That's far enough, for this kind of...
Because 8 actually doesn't sound like that much at the moment.
I think 8 is good enough for office use, if you want to be a little bit more powerful. Multimedia, maybe 4 already. I mean,
but some people have very specific tasks where maybe more memory is
a
thing.
This is the M.2 SSD over here.
Well, Makoto, you ask who won. It's you, actually.
Yeah,
it's you. We just don't know how to...
Pronounce your last name.
Frethel? I don't know. Frethel?
Makoto.
Well, that's why we take the last part of the name, because that's actually quite easy to...
Prethi. And you won. Congratulations.
Yeah, so it's you.
Yeah.
Congrats.
That's also what I do. If I win, I'm going, hey, so who?
Can we? What?
Yeah, which name?
What's my name?
Yeah.
All right.
You see, capitals.
Yeah, I know. So he or she knows.
No, she.
I don't know.
Yeah, she knows.
But yeah, they know.
They know they won.
Yeah. Yeah, so first I'm going to install an extra SSD. So we already have an M.2
inside.
SSD inside.
Yeah.
And this SSD can be either NVMe, it can run NVMe or can run SATA. Hmm. So NVMe, of course, PCI Express protocol, so it's much faster, but of course a little bit more expensive. So this one has an Intel 600P installed. Okay, so what I'm going to do, the hard drive, here, this is the, I didn't show this in detail, so this is the cable.
That's the part, the white connector is the part that you have to connect to the PCB.
Yeah, so below the M.2 SSD, there is a small white connector.
Yes. And just can you show it a little bit closer maybe, because it was a little bit unclear, I think. There you go. So you have a blue connector there, that's obviously SATA. If you've ever seen that, then you know. The other one there with the, how many pins is that? Five, something like that? Anyway, the little white connector, that's the part that you're looking for right now, that's the power connector.
Yeah, so I'm going to plug this one in the white one.
Yes. Mm. Without bending the pins.
Well, I need to check which way, how this goes. It's not like this, so it should be like this. Only fits one way.
Yes.
Okay.
It's like USB.
So, yeah. There you have it. So then, secondly, I'm going to install the short SATA cable.
And as you can see, one end is black and the other end is blue. And usually when two colors match up...
It doesn't matter.
I don't know, but maybe it's always best to match the two colors.
It doesn't matter at all.
Because maybe there's a reason why one is blue.
Yeah, sometimes, but not in this case. So this one is the SATA connector for the signal, for the data. So now you have two short cables connected. So now I'm going to take the... I don't have screws for that. Anyway, I'm going to show you. So you plug in the...
Power.
Power.
You have to, there's only one way to do it, so yeah, Eric is trying to figure out which way it is.
It's upside down.
There you go.
And then this one,
that makes sense, because the underside is where the holes are here, you can see on the SSD.
So this is the top of the SSD.
Yeah.
In reality, it doesn't matter. But on the top, there are no screwing holes, so these are screws.
Yeah.
And on the bottom...
You have screw holes to fix the... the SSD to something.
So, and if you then take the bottom of the QB,
you can see. Yeah. It's let me just point it out before you go. These holes, basically, this one, and that one, and that one.
So then
those align.
Fits
exactly.
Like this.
Yes, and so you can fix it to the bottom side of the QB.
And then if you have QB, we have the SSD fixed like this, you can close it like this.
Yes. There you go. And then upgrade it.
Yeah, I'm not going to do that right now because I don't have these screws.
Screws,
The four screws.
Yeah.
That's because I didn't prepare. Right?
I'm not saying anything.
Let's go to main view that people don't have to see how I'm damaging everything.
you actually clicked the button there in the background.
Oh. Yeah, like this.
Yes. I don't even see what you're doing. I don't want to see. I don't think. Sorry if this has been asked before, but when is the release date? So
it's already on the market.
If you mean the QB, yes.
Yeah.
And if you mean the game that you can win today, actually, let me check.
The game launched the 7th or something?
26th of January 2018, but that might be...
No, that's old one. You need to have ISO.
Yeah. Let me see. That one is actually...
Iceborne. I think somewhere beginning of January. 9th of January.
Yeah, 9th of January, exactly. Yeah,
I have 7th. So
it's out already. Both the product and the game are out. So
yeah.
Well, let me put the chat back. There we go.
Okay. I think we should.
You want to put it back together and do a quick power usage test? Because before we start pulling it apart,
we don't have to.
Well, we don't have to do anything.
Well, no. What I want to say, we don't have to put. Oh. Let me take the memory out. Let me put this aside.
Yeah.
I don't think we have to assemble it.
Sure.
I mean, it probably runs like this.
So we want to see here. I've got a. This is a bit awkward because we only had one a power meter here. Nice. Did you just pull that out of your crack?
Yeah, well, yeah. It's ticking everywhere, Peter.
Anyway, so we've got one meter here, but as you can see, and it will show what. But as
Let
you
me
can
switch
see,
it on.
I have to like hold it upside down for you guys to actually see.
So and now it's booting. Let me take my microphone so you hear the noise.
And remember, this is the power for the whole system. It's the whole QB. So
I don't know how loud the noise is, but you know, at the boot you hear it, and now you don't hear anything anymore. And I'm holding my microphone next to the QB, so maybe it's very loud. But yeah, normally it's like whisper,
quiet.
Yeah.
Just pretty much silent. You don't really hear it.
Yeah, you don't hear anything. Now it's booted. It's running in idle. Probably it already booted in Windows. Yeah. I just saw 20. And now it's like 17, 15 yeah. I saw. Probably it's still booting up some materials. No, the HUD light is not flashing anymore.
Yeah. So here it's actually below 10 now.
Yeah, so now it runs in Windows idle mode. It's waiting for some assignments.
Probably to log in as well. Maybe?
Yeah.
Like a login screen?
I think this is... Yeah, it can be login screen.
Probably. Anyway.
Yeah, so let's say if this is your server at home and runs 24 hours per day in idle, it you know, like a storage server for your cloud, for your home cloud, or like for torrents.
It's probably taking less power than your Christmas lights.
Absolutely.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Even if it's LED, well, especially if it's LED.
And I'm sorry, I cannot put it in the load now because I should put some heavy program there or play a game to really see the power usage. But it's a 25 watt TDP CPU and the power adapter is 65 watt. So it will never reach that.
It has a little bit of headroom, but probably indeed it won't even go there.
Yeah.
But as you can see, normally if it's just in Windows and idling, and that's pretty much what you have if you use it as a server.
Yeah, indeed.
Most of the time it's just idling and then it's just...
So don't be confused. I mean, I don't want to make any false promises. This is in idle. Huh? So if you're running a benchmark on it...
it will be higher.
Yeah, it will triple to like 20, 25%.
25 watts, you mean? Or a bit higher, maybe.
Yeah. Can it also work with Google Assistant, Alexa, Siri? Ooh. Why not?
Very specific
questions. Edwin, you are asking so many difficult questions.
Don't get us wrong. They are good questions, but they are very specific scenarios. Yeah. So,
to be honest, I'm Siri, no, because
that's Apple.
Siri is Apple, indeed.
So unless you can run that from a Windows client, then yes. Alexa, or a Hackintosh, maybe.
Alexa, I don't know, because I don't know what the Windows... You know, it depends on how you mean, can it work with. I mean, if you install software like Home Automation, something like Home Assistant, for example, open source platform.
Google Home Assistant. And you
No, not Google, not Google. Home Assistant. It's a platform for automating your home.
Yeah.
So,
but you have, I mean, potentially, you also, I mean, you can connect a microphone in this, so
I think he's more talking about can it like with Zigbee and those kind of protocols. It has USB, so you connect the dongles to it.
Yeah.
So this works perfectly for Home Assistant. That's no problem. But can you, like what Peter was trying to answer, talk to this like it's I don't know,
smart speaker and stuff like that?
Not,
you know,
by
commands.
Default, but probably there is some software.
You can probably get it to work if you want to, if you put in enough work.
Reminds me to take down the Christmas lights.
Yeah, I also still have to do that.
We already did at home. I was, you know, I saved a lot of money in the last year. I replaced all the lights with LEDs. So I saved like up to 50 to 65% on electricity, and then Christmas. So two Christmas trees. I was like, what are those lights? Don't ask.
Yeah.
I said, okay.
Just do. It's only a couple of weeks.
After New Year, remove ASAP.
Oh. I like them, you know, having them around, especially when it's still dark when I get home. And then it's just nice to see out, at least, you know, on the inside of the house, sure, they're gone. But on the outside of the house, I still have some lights up, so yeah, looks nice.
Anyway, so that's the power usage. So now
Edwin, I think Eric was saying Zigbee, not XB.
No, yeah, Zigbee indeed.
Yeah, he's saying XB, that's old school. So maybe not quite that old school, but sure. Are you trying to assassinate
Okay, so what we're now going to try to do, let me see the time.
Yeah, we've got a little bit of time.
Yeah, so I'm going to try to disassemble this. We didn't do this before.
No.
There's something inside what I lost.
Yeah, exactly.
So I need to do it anyway, right?
See if you can recover it.
Yeah, so...
Do we want to get into the close-up view for
this? Yeah, maybe.
So yeah, I think so that people don't see your face when you go through this?
Can I do like this? I have something better.
Yeah, you can hold it up there.
Yeah. Oh, la la la. So there are two screws here. Can you maybe hold the webcam? Maybe that's better because I... Yeah, okay, anyway.
Well, no, not
so
really.
I'm going to...
I can monitor the chat for you.
Well, you should make photos because then we know which screw goes where. Okay. Let me first take out these components. So this is the memory I'm taking out right now.
Yeah.
This is the...
So Eric S, yeah, I mean, we already answered that. Can it run Crysis? It doesn't get much further than Cry.
My screwdriver
it will start to cry
too
if you,
big, so
if you try
I have
to
a smaller
that.
One here. I hope this one works. Yes.
So this is the M.2 coming out.
It's magnetic. Mostly.
Yeah. Do we have, maybe here, it's the little popcorn thing. You put the screws in there.
So, I don't lose them.
Don't.
That's good.
Don't try to eat it.
So, this is the M.2 SSD which is installed.
What's the little thing underneath it that's still stuck to it?
Chewing gum.
Yeah, but is it like purely spacer? Or is it also a little bit thermal?
It's a spacer, but it's right. Transparent.
Yeah, green PCB.
It's a spacer, but it's like a thermal compound, so okay. It also
helps a little bit passively.
Helps a little bit with cooling, indeed. Yeah. So yeah, as you can see, this is like this Intel SSD. So going to put this apart of a side.
D-Pack graphics card. It's an Intel iGPU that's in there.
Yes. I'm going to put it like this. Then here, below the M.2 slot, we have a Wi-Fi module.
Right. It's the Intel Wi-Fi module, right?
This is the Intel Wi-Fi module.
Yes.
So there's a small screw over here. So let me take the other screwdriver.
The smaller one. Actually, they're keeping scores, Eric. They're saying hashtag Eric versus QB, 1-0.
Yeah, well, this is, it seems to be
You're still ahead at the moment.
Yeah, I wonder how long.
It's okay. We'll see, the chat will keep the score, right? You guys will keep the score?
Yeah, so this is a plastic protection cover.
Yeah.
And this is what I hate. I'm not sure if somebody ever opened a mobile phone. I did. And it still runs.
You're not supposed to.
Yeah, I know, but it's very small, and you know I'm getting old. My eyes are getting bad. But yeah. These two cables are antennas for Wi-Fi, and I'm going to disconnect one. Here.
You have a little tweezer.
Yeah. So I look like a professional. Normally, I just put my screwdriver below it.
Yeah.
So I need to hold it.
They love the transparent M.2, by the way.
Yeah, that happens. So these two, I'm going to...
Very carefully. It's very delicate.
I'm going to do this off camera, guys. Okay,
no.
the problem is it's already... Okay, just like this. It's here, and then... Now they're disconnected, so...
So those are actually not soldered. They kind of looked a little bit like they were soldered on.
No. Over here...
Very small connectors.
You have the connectors, and they're really small in the... I'm not sure the focus of the camera. In the middle, you see a small dot.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, imagine, you know, trying to put this on. And in mobile phones, they are even smaller for the antennas and all the connectors.
They're even, yeah.
Yeah, so
even more compact.
Can you see at the top which one this is?
How do you mean?
If this is 200AX, I don't believe so.
No. Let me check. Oh, way at the top. No, this is the 9462NGW.
Yeah, so that's Wi-Fi 5.
Yes.
Okay, so now
it is tiny, guys.
We took out all the
way at the top there. The
camera. There you go. Hey, cool. Now I can also read it.
Yeah.
So will MSI come with an Intel CPU and graphics card PCI Express setup? How do you mean? Intel CPU card. No. I think he's talking about the new Intel platform.
Oh, the NUC.
The new NUC Extreme.
The one that they presented at CES.
To be honest, I didn't read all CES news. Well, we're looking into it, that's for sure. But we don't have any concrete plan for now or products to announce. If so, probably early set Computex, I would say. And Computex is in the beginning of June, yes. So now I removed everything. You can still see some things. I'm going to check if, I can pull them.
See if you can put it. These are spacers, kind of, I guess.
Yeah.
But also maybe they will catch some acoustics, because you know, it's foam.
Yeah, there is some glue or some tape on there.
Yeah, just to keep them in place.
I'm not sure if the main board is already...
Maybe you don't have to remove them, actually.
Yeah, I need to check. Okay, we see
a
small cable.
Yeah.
So I'm going to disconnect it.
It's one of the...
I think it's for the power on, or for the LED.
Okay.
No, it's not for the LED. Anyway,
it's one of the things on the front.
Yeah, sorry guys, I disconnect it, you see? It's like a snake.
Yeah, it's one of those small, it's not a ribbon cable, but you know, a very small cable there, connector.
How's the score?
I don't know, guys, chat, what's the score?
Oh, you see? It's coming out. So only the two screws did it, but it's stuck somewhere. What? That's how you do it normally, not? I think... Anyway.
I don't know. That's how you do it.
Yeah, I need to really check if there's some... we should practice this.
No. This was supposed to be the spontaneous part where
let me see. There is, I think the power button is the issue here. No.
Are there any screws left?
This one is not here anymore. No. No screws left. This part is moving already. So this part is moving already. So it's really stuck in the front. We have the Wi-Fi antennas. So maybe I put them between this. And later we're surprised they're not working anymore. Maybe I can take out the metal case.
Who knows?
You see, the back is already moving.
Yeah. So what is it holding it back at the front?
Need
to check. Maybe there's
my USB key is still inside. That could be, right?
Maybe there's a little
it's
latch or something that needs
bit.
To be...
Okay, let's remove these two parts.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
I see some additional... Oh, you already removed this one.
Maybe the tape, let's remove that as well.
Yeah, you guys can see that very carefully. This was a working sample when we started this stream.
So it's some silver tape.
Thermally.
Probably, yeah.
I don't want to say conductive. Probably more like, you know, it resists.
It's part of that, I believe. Okay, well, I don't see any... Okay, this cable is already... maybe it looks like it's the LED. But that's soldered on it.
So you'll have to bend it out of place or something. Or break it off.
Okay, probably it's like this. And then just pull. Normally it's pull. Let me check if there's something. No. I guess we just take it out.
There you go. That's not bad at all.
Yeah.
Not bad, Eric.
Okay, let's first check the inside here.
Yep. So there's the little part. I saw it moving.
Oh, yeah.
There it is. Yes.
Here it is. This is what we lost.
Yeah.
This is what Peter lost. What?
Sure.
Okay.
But it's a placeholder because, you know, if you're not using the extended power button, basically, you want to have that hole plugged so, it, you know, dust doesn't get in there and stuff. So.
I see. More screws.
You do?
Yeah, here at the bottom.
So what is...
I don't know. I think it's Wi-Fi antenna because I see the Wi-Fi... Yeah, this is Wi-Fi antenna.
Right.
Let me do like this.
Yes.
At the left side, okay, or whatever side, this side and this side.
Yeah.
You see two screws at the bottom and at the top. Right. And the Wi-Fi antennas, these two...
They go in there. Yeah.
They go in there. One black and then one gray.
And one of the gray wires then comes out and goes to the other side.
Yeah. So I'm going to... You need a bigger one for this, I guess.
Hope the warranty is still valid after this. I doubt it. I highly doubt it. But it would be a nice experiment. Let's see if we can get some warranty after this.
I think it's quite easy. I think I can put it back together.
It's not too bad, I have to say. For such a small system, it's not that hard to take apart.
Well, it's not apart yet.
That's true. We still have to look at the thermals and stuff like that.
And stuff. Yeah. So, but let's
see if we can see some shots of the CPU later on.
Okay. So this is...
Show it to the camera.
Well, I mean, this is mounted with the two screws on the bottom.
Right.
So this is the Wi-Fi antenna.
Yeah.
But you know, I'm not really familiar with notebooks. So I see this part is soldered at some foam.
Yeah.
But I think the foam doesn't let go. I'm not sure if it's soldered.
Yeah. But it looks like that whole plaque there, pretty much, is kind of like...
But this is like foam?
The antenna. Yeah, but the part on top of it.
Yeah, I think this is the antenna.
Yes. Looks like it.
Yeah, and I mean, I think it's really... Oh, no. Oh, shit.
Did you just poke a hole in the antenna?
Yeah. check this, guys.
Eric just poked a hole.
I thought this was like foam. I could get separated.
Yeah.
But there is some copper inside, and that means it's part of the antenna.
And that means that probably right now it's damaged. So that's fine.
Well, I mean, this is how you learn, right?
Yes.
Don't poke in things you should not poke inside. What else? Well, the button at the front, it's a push button.
Anthony Smirnis, your question, how powerful is this mini PC? Can it run games without catching fire? If you rewatch this stream, we actually covered that earlier on the stream. So you can, if you rewatch the stream, you can see that as well. Apparently, the score is 1-1 now. I also don't know why you're putting your glass of water that close to your working laptop that's on.
Living on the edge.
Yeah,
Peter.
Apparently.
Yeah. I was just showing the power connector.
This is getting uncomfortable for me seeing that because I know what you can do with water.
Yeah, like last time. Okay, so this is the power button, and over here you see it's just pushing to the inside.
Yeah.
And then on the PCB over there, normally this is quite simple. On the PCB over there, you have this push button focus,
click.
It pushes this button.
Yeah, that's it.
Simple mechanism.
It's very simple.
Yeah, and that's all on the inside.
Pretty much.
So we have one antenna, Wi-Fi antenna here, one Wi-Fi antenna here.
The rest of the metal casing is probably because of structural strength.
And
you know,
this
to
one,
give it...
I don't know what this one is. This in the middle.
It's, I think, part of the case design. Like I said, you know, this is one of the parts probably that clicks into the metal thing to give it a bit of more structural strength. The whole thing. I don't think it has any use in terms of or any additional functionality apart from structural strength.
Next. Let's talk about this. So this is the motherboard. Can you have the mini ITX mainboard still, Peter? Can you get it?
Yeah, of course.
Not sure where you put it.
It's a bit covered with popcorn. But that's
maybe
fine.
the front cam.
The main cam.
The main cam,
yeah.
There we
go.
Yeah, so...
Actually, you maybe can do this in a detailed cam, because they are both quite small.
Yeah, but
that's difficult. Okay, yeah, never mind. Main can.
So this is difference in PCB size. So both are square, and yeah, I don't know, but this looks like 20, and this is like 10, maybe 10 by 10.
About,
I mean, where's
yeah.
the? Oh, we put it on the back of the monitor. Yeah, probably 10 by 10, or maybe even smaller.
Something like that.
Really small.
11 by 11.
Okay, so let's have a look over here, what we have.
Detailed cam.
So rear I.O. We already talked about.
Yes.
And these cushions...
they don't do it well.
I don't know why they are. We need to check. It looks like there's something for thermal because of the material on the outside.
I think it's indeed for both thermal, but also to give it maybe some acoustic. Because again, there's a fan in this, so it will absorb some
but
of the noise.
The fan is on the other side.
I know, but still, the sound bounces around the whole case. So it will absorb some. And also, I think to prevent that, you know, there's space between this and the cover. And you want to prevent that it, you know, becomes... You saw how easy it actually came loose with just two or three screws. So that means that if those screws were to somehow become undone, you know, this thing will be bouncing around inside the casing. And actually, these cushions will probably prevent that from happening.
I found a secret connector. This one we didn't disconnect, right?
Which one?
This one.
I don't know.
I don't think so.
Wasn't it... I can't remember, actually.
Can you check and log in again? So this is the front I.O. We already talked a little bit about it. So you have the audio connectors. So this is how they look on the inside. You have two capacitors here on the edge of the PCB. Not sure why they're there. You have USB connector. It looks blue. SATA connector over here, and here you have the Type-C connector. Yes. Here you have an LED, which is a little bit bent. I don't know why. And here you have the small connector. It's the fan connector.
That's probably
You know the one I disconnected, and probably I don't have to disconnect it, but that's the fan connector.
Right.
Can we boot it like this?
You can try, but...
Yeah, why not?
Somebody was making a joke, like, push the power connector, and I thought, you know, just no, don't, but... Oh my God, Eric. It's actually, fan is spinning.
Don't do this at home.
Yeah, Eric is being electrocuted right now.
The LED is quite bright.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to... So yeah, fan is spinning.
Yeah, but there's no memory in it.
There's no memory, no OS, so it's probably not, it's probably stuck at the BIOS.
Yeah. No SSD, nothing connected, so it can't get into
OS. Yeah, these people don't see anything.
Yeah. And Eric was now going to pull the plug because it was just a simple test. Will it turn on as well, like this?
Yeah. So it's still working.
Yeah.
Conclusion.
For now.
It's 2-1.
Yeah. Well, judges?
It's 2-1.
What is your ruling?
So here we have a fan, which I'm now going to remove.
The thermal system.
Yeah, I'm just going to dump this at Ruud's.
Which reminds me a lot of, also again, a laptop thermal, right?
Yeah. So...
The capacitors are close to the audio out. I can assume it needs to be near the audio circuit. Probably, yeah. I don't know for sure if those capacitors are for the audio.
But let us check
these ones.
Yeah. Probably you're right because this is very difficult to see. That square chip over there with the small crab.
No, what is it? Yeah, it's the Realtek logo.
Yeah, it's a crab. This is Realtek.
Yes.
So probably indeed you're right. It's for audio because
does it say on there? It's an ALC something something.
Yes.
What is it? Can you hold it closer so we can read it? Closer.
And now it needs to focus.
Focus.
Oh, not my finger, sorry.
Oh. A bit more.
No,
let me do it.
Okay. Oh, watch out, the fan is...
Let me see.
Oh yeah, you're real pro.
Oh, crap.
Where are you? It's on the other side.
Oh man, so it's actually... Yeah, this sucks.
Yeah, okay.
No, we almost had it. Here we go.
ALC... Something 7.
387 or something?
No.
Let me see. Maybe I can see in real life.
Yeah, of course, you have glasses.
Wow.
This is indeed very small.
Michiel could read it. I told him
887. I don't know the chipsets by heart.
You're right. This is for audio indeed.
887. Yeah. So somebody's already saying it.
Yeah. Here are the audio, the microphone and the headphone.
Yes.
Audio chip. So indeed. So let's take this apart.
If you just joined the stream, yes, welcome. This is the part where we break the product we just talked about the rest of the stream.
Yeah. So I just unscrewed two. Okay.
Yep. So that's so just the fan.
This is the fan.
Yep.
The fan intake. Yeah. Or exhaust. I'm not sure.
Both, actually. It's just, the intake is actually more from the top and the bottom.
This again. We really need to have an engineering manual in order to. To put it back together.
Yes.
This is a fan. It's quite thin.
Yeah. So basically, the air intake and basically it comes from both this side and the other side, and the exhaust is here because that's where it blows it into the heatsink.
Yeah.
So it's like a mini exhaust fan, as we call it, with the graphics cards as well.
Yeah.
And so, no, actually, I'm wrong, because it. I see there's a heat pipe directly beneath it as well, yeah. So it will blow it downwards and into
It's controllable because it has four pins. Yeah. Is it four pins?
Three.
Yeah, so four? It's four pins.
Four, yeah.
Yeah, I'm checking the cable.
PWM, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
There you go.
Then.
Underneath that, just show them what you found underneath. So you see there's quite a thick heat pipe. This thing?
Yeah.
I'm assuming that underneath here is the CPU.
Yes, because there is no GPU and there is no chipset. Yep. It's all in
what indicated. Else would be there? Yeah. But you can see there's also still a fin stack here, an array of fins, which also, so the heat is, actually, sorry, the air is being blown down onto the heat pipe. And then the heat pipe also goes around. Actually, it goes underneath into this, it also runs underneath this fin stack.
Yeah.
So.
So now we
That's
are going
pretty
to
much where
remove
it gets
this
all
part, and this is a little bit.
Is it tricky?
No, not tricky. Doesn't matter. I like tricky.
Uh-huh. It looks like you'll have to remove the.
I think it's these ones.
Yeah, on the other side, because these are the ones holding the. Yeah.
Is it? Is everything?
Probably.
Yeah, everything is floating. Okay, yeah. So. Everything is floating except for over here. we see some cushion,
a spacer.
Spacer indeed. Yes. And the rest is all floating and attached to the CPU.
Yeah. So if you screw, there's four screws, I think.
I'm going to be fired for this.
Worth it.
Yeah. Sorry.
Oh no, I left for 30 minutes and Eric already broke it. Hashtag blame Eric. Yeah, you're right, Hussein. You leave him alone for 10 seconds and this is what happens.
Yeah, it's... a moment. Need to keep it like this.
Don't try this at home, folks.
Yeah, it's quite difficult for me to unscrew this because I want to that you can see it, and at the same time I need to hold it steady.
Yeah.
So that's not easy.
This is usually how I feel like when I have to upgrade a GPU, you know, on cam.
Yeah,
you have to
do it in a way that's
unnatural for you.
Yeah. Okay. So I unscrewed it. Now we are going to
remove it. Well, that wasn't so hard.
No. Quite easy.
Can you show the bottom side of the heatsink? There you go. So you see, these are the spacers, right?
Or at least... No. These are the thermal pads.
Ah, right. Yeah. Okay. And then there's a little bit of thermal grease on there, as you can see.
Yeah.
So it seems to have like a cold plate, or at least a mounting mechanism there. I think that's a nickel plated. It's very similar to a nickel plated copper base plate. That's then connected to the thermal.
Yeah, that's a different difference, because if we talk about our CPU coolers, or for example our water coolers, if we talk about our motherboards, if we talk about our GPUs, we all know the specs of the heat sinks of the cooler.
Yeah.
But this is a complete system.
Yeah.
Let's say it's a complete PC. So we don't have these details at our hand. So
we get them like this.
Yeah. And we didn't practice this before, so no. we didn't know what to expect, and we didn't ask questions like, hey, what is this for?
Should we do this?
That's why we didn't ask.
Those kinds of questions you really shouldn't ask yourself if you're in this business.
Yeah. Okay, so let me see.
Show them. Just show them the other side of the PC.
Yeah. So this is the PCB. I'm trying to get a good angle.
So basically, the CPU is at, if you hold the QB the right side
so
up,
this
the CPU
here,
is at the bottom
here we see
of
some,
the PCB.
Still some thermal pad. Let me try to remove this.
So there's a little chip under there, right? There's a memory chip?
No.
What is it?
Cache? To be honest, I don't know the configuration of the CPU, but this can be either the chipset, or let's say the chipset, or it can be the GPU.
Right.
And to be honest, this is the, you know, normally we don't talk about mobile. So in our team, we also don't take care of mobile.
No, it's not
so
thing.
Yeah, we know a lot about VGA. We know a lot about the desktop CPUs. We don't know a lot about mobile CPUs. But I talked with our notebook team, and this year we will do more notebook live streams.
Yes.
And then, yeah, we also need to know how this works.
Yeah.
So probably somebody in live stream knows what this is.
Make sure you don't tell them and don't show them this video, because then they might not send us samples.
One moment. I'm going to try to find some...
Let's see if we can get a little close-up action going here. So as you can see, it looks like a typical thing of a GPU there, because it's so friggin' shiny as well. So that might be the... integrated GPU.
Oh my god. So I just took something to clean this. Normally we are prepared. Okay. So normally you clean it.
Yeah.
And
this is an i7, right? I mean, it's also quite impressive.
No, I think in this is the i5 configuration.
Oh, the i5. All right. Okay. Well, fair enough. I mean, then the i7 might be just slightly bigger.
No.
It's the same size, physically.
I think it's the same size. Normally, if we go back to the CPU part,
yes.
It matters in cores, of course, and in clock speeds. Oh my god, everything is cooling paste.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, it can differ a little bit in... No, one moment. Okay, can we have the detailed cam again?
Of course. There we go.
Yeah, so now you see the two pieces of silicon. There are some scratches on there. I don't know why this happened. Yeah.
I think this happens after a while
let me
anyway.
Let me see if this is upside down or not at the bottom. Is this upside down?
No, I think this is the right way up.
Yeah, so what can we see here? First of all, we have the battery. I found a thermal pad.
Oh.
I don't know. This is probably from the top chip.
Yeah.
Anybody in the chip?
You could put it on here. Because there's the space for it, apparently.
Yeah. So the VRM is located over here. You see the MOSFETs.
Three.
There are more. I don't know the configuration of this, how this is configured. I'm not a VRM expert.
I think three big
chokes.
We
have another connector, which I don't know what it's for. Oh, it says... RGB?
Probably.
No.
Christmas tree.
Not RGB.
No.
So, but you see on the normal mainboards, we always solder the battery on the PCB. But in this case, mini ITX boards and this like QB, we just have a connector. We put the battery in some wrapping, plastic wrap to protect it, and it's just glued on the PCB. I'm not sure. Yeah, it's not easy to take off. So I don't want to pull some chips off. Let me see what I can find. I see ME. AMI. Yeah, it's with the light here. But
Anyway, so it's a custom PCB.
Yeah, it is completely custom PCB. So over here you have some chips. I cannot read it. Maybe if we hold it closer up. But you can think about USB chips. You can think about Intel LAN controller should be there. The Wi-Fi is on a module we showed you earlier. Yeah. So that's no
it's
need
on the
to
table here. So it's not on the PCB.
Yeah. Here you see some high C caps, which we also use on the motherboards.
Yep. And graphics cards as well. Yeah. So it seems like they're also using, because I see some very familiar components there that probably we're also using on some of our motherboards and graphics cards, which makes sense.
Yeah.
But it also means that you could, it's probably very similar in quality as well. So the great quality that we strive to have on our components is also present in products like the Qubi.
Yeah, I should have some extra light and
a magnifying glass
indeed to see all the chips which they are, and of course schematics also help.
Well, yeah. But I mean, this is already quite okay for as far as a teardown goes.
So
we've seen a lot of the inside now.
So I should not put the CPU at a.
Wow. Doesn't matter. The thermal paste is off already.
Yeah.
Not off your hands, but
no,
off
indeed,
the CPU.
indeed. So maybe
another winner. Time for another winner.
Yeah.
I'll put the. Let's go back to the main view. There we go. Eric, you do the talking.
Okay. Well, I think this is one of the last winners. Just do two.
Yeah, two.
Yeah, come on.
All right.
We talk too much.
Yeah, we talk and we destroy too much. We tear too much down. Okay, two winners. Winner one.
Okay.
Name is Bryce Hens.
Come on. I want to do this. Bryce, congratulations. Yep. And Paula, also congratulations with your Monstrant Iceborne game code. It's the game and the DLC. If not, just let me know. Yes. Then we will fix this.
Yes. So congratulations. We'll get the codes out to you in the coming days.
Yeah.
I think.
So this is for Qubi.
Yeah.
I hope it was interesting.
Yeah.
We wanted to do something different this week because, normally Qubi is for a commercial business.
It's not something you would think about for your own home usage, but surprisingly enough, because it is quite powerful with up to an i7, it could be interesting.
We just fake it. This is Qubi.
Yeah. we thought it might be interesting. If you please let us know if you like this kind of content or not. I think it's one of our first proper teardowns. We try to do this more often, but most of the time we are quite careful because they're working samples and they're required later on to be still working. So we are usually quite
careful
with them.
What is the score?
I don't know. I didn't keep score. Guys, judges, yeah. what is the score?
Did I win?
Yeah. Who won? Qubi or Eric?
Okay, maybe we can still power it on. No. The fan is off because otherwise it might burn. Not now.
But yeah, we hope you like this kind of content. If not, if you are missing things or would like to see different things in future streams, you can always let us know.
Yeah, let us know. We are working on a lot of nice ideas for 2020. Yeah. Ideas we want. Of course, we always have the new products we're going to do. Sometimes, from time to time, we will do some gameplay, with Overcooked. But
and we'll try to show you exclusive things when we can.
Some events, etc.
Yeah, or when we are in our headquarters, as you saw earlier last year well. So
and the headquarters one, I mean, this takes a lot of preparation.
Yes.
And we only showed you, sometimes we're there and we wanted to show you also the thermal testing chamber for VGA.
Yeah.
But it was booked by OEM.
Yeah.
By OEM team, we also do some business for some big OEM partners.
Yeah.
And then it's very difficult to get access to that. So these things need to be arranged far ahead of time.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then everything needs to be arranged in the same week or day.
Yeah.
If you have some nice ideas for some content, what you want to see from us, what you want to hear from us, let us know. And we are going to look into it. And this will not be the week after.
No.
Because next week, we already have a topic.
Yes, because next week, we're going to be talking about the RX 5600 XT.
Yes.
This is the card that was announced by AMD.
Can I do a teardown again?
I should not.
I don't know. I mean, you're there. But you can try.
And
We will see if I will allow it.
That would be...
Maybe I should do it that
Why
time.
Not? They're keeping scores?
Yeah, I don't know. I didn't see the score. RX 5600 XT. And the main question I think everybody's asking is, you know, is it 1080p Ultra territory like AMD says, or is it also pretty decent for 4040p? So you'll have to find out by joining the stream next week. We'll be discussing it. We'll be showing benchmarks, and you'll know more about it. Yeah. So if you're interested in that, or just generally in the GPU progress and then
Nice idea. I see some nice ideas. China factory.
We can send somebody there.
Tear down keyboards and cleaning it. That's your part. Actually, it should be Michiel.
Oh my God,
Mike.
Do you really want to see him sit there, you know, with a sponge going and a toothbrush going, you made me do this, now you watch.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah, the factories are in China, indeed. Our headquarters is based in Taiwan, but all the factories in China, indeed.
Yes.
Hey, 2-1.
All right, so it looks like Eric won this round. Ding, ding.
Ding, ding.
Next round, next week. And thanks for joining for now. And
I will keep this for next week.
We hope to see you guys next week. Maybe we can see if we can get the QB running again and you know, follow up on that. So you guys can see if we actually got it running again or not.
My assignment for tomorrow.
Yeah.
Will be a puzzle.
Who knows?
That should be doable.
Yeah, we'll see.
Well, back together or running?
Running. So back together and running.
Okay.
Because that's kind of, anyway. So thank you guys for joining. We'll see you guys next week.
Thank you all. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.